Charles, I'm going to say that you invented an algorithm just now that we're going to call policy iteration. It's kind of like value iteration, except it's going to iterate in policy space.
I'm so smart.
Yeah, though you invented it a little bit too late because it dates back to, 1960 or thereabout.
Dijkstra always has ideas before I do.
Yeah, Dijkstra's pretty clever, but this was actually Ron Howard.
You mean the Ron Howard, the rector?
Oh, sorry, no. It's the Ron Howard, the algorithm designer.
Oh, that one. I always get them confused.
One played Opie, and the other one proved contraction mappings.
They're very similar things.
So this is what I was imagining you were explaining. Here, let's take it step by step. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off picking an arbitrary Q function, like we often do. We'll call that the initialization step. Then we're going to iterate the following. We're going to take the tth Q function and compute its greedy policy, call that pi sub t. Then that policy, we're going to evaluate it to get a new Q function, qt plus 1. And then we're going to repeat and iterate this over and over and over again. So each time we go around this loop, we're taking our previous Q function, finding its greedy policy, taking that greedy policy, finding its value function, and repeating.
Lather, rinse, repeat.
Exactly. So unlike when I take a shower, we actually get convergence in finite time. So in particular, the sequence of Q functions that we get converges to Q star, which is good. That's like how policy iteration works.
Mm-hmm.
But even better, the convergence is exact and complete in finite time.
Mm.
Though I guess that was kind of true of value iteration as well. And it converges at least as fast as value iteration in that if at any point we sync up the Q functions, we start value iteration and policy iteration from the same Q function, then each step that policy iteration takes is moving us towards the optimal Q function no more slowly than value iteration does.
Okay.
So that kind of suggests that this is just, way better.
Yeah, isn't it way better?
So why is it not way better? There's kind of some excitement going on in here that that we need to take into consideration. There is a bit of a trade-off, as you like to say.
Mm-hmm. What's the trade-off?
So where's the trade-off here? We're getting faster convergence at the cost of greater computational expense. So in particular, this step, this policy evaluation step that says take the policy and then work out the Q function for that policy, you can do that by, say, solving a system of linear equations or, perhaps more commonly, by running something kind of like value iteration to completion.
Mm.
So in the inner loop of policy iteration is something that's an awful lot like value iteration. And so maybe it's not so surprising that it goes at least as fast as value iteration. It's doing a lot more work than value iteration. Each iteration of policy iteration is doing pretty much all the work of value iteration.
Yeah, well, so it just depends upon what you're counting. I say we just count the outer loop.
Then we win, or at least we don't lose. In fact, this is kind of an interesting, outstanding question. So we don't really know how many iterations policy iteration takes. So an open question is what the convergence time really is. We know a couple things about it, but it turns out to be fairly weak. We know that there are some MDPs such that the number of iterations that policy iteration takes is linear, at least as large as the number of states in the MDP. Though we can't, I don't think anybody's actually shown like two times the number of states. So there's all we know is something really, really basic, which is that it takes at least number of states iterations in the worst case. And we know it can't be any worse than number of actions raised to the number of states, an exponential. But where it sits in between, we don't really know. And so if it's closer to linear, then it's totally awesome and it blows the doors off of value iteration. If it's more like exponential, then it's probably still better than value iteration, but it's definitely more of a wash.